The AstraZeneca vaccine has been praised for its cost-effectiveness and its easy-to-store advantages. But recent cases of blood clots have been linked to the vaccine. Should you be worried? I'll explain. The AstraZeneca vaccine. I've been getting a lot of comments from you wanting this vaccine discussed. Today, I'm going to go over key facts that you need to know about the AstraZeneca vaccine, such as how is it different from Pfizer, Moderna, and Johnson & Johnson. Also, we'll be going over questions like, what is the AstraZeneca COVID vaccine made of? And will we even need a fourth vaccine option added here in the United States? We have lots to talk about. Hey everyone, I'm Dr. Jordan Wagner. I'm an emergency room doctor who treats everything from COVID to gunshot wounds, burns, you name it. I've created this video series to help answer your questions and the questions that I get from patients each and every day, like you. If you find this video helpful, please hit that like button and subscribe to my channel so you are notified of the latest news and medical tips. So how is the AstraZeneca COVID-19 vaccine different from the others? And how does it work exactly? AstraZeneca's vaccine uses adenovirus vector technology. This altered virus cannot make you sick, but it carries a gene from the novel coronavirus spike protein and triggers an immune response. In other words, AstraZeneca's vaccine mimics a COVID-19 infection without its actual life-threatening side effects, per a release from the company. Johnson & Johnson's vaccine also relies on a similar adenovirus vector technology. The Pfizer, BioNTech, and Moderna vaccines, on the other hand, rely on mRNA technology. Both approved vaccines require two shots spaced about a month apart. In the meantime, it's likely manufacturers are working toward greater protection against new variants as well. How effective is the AstraZeneca COVID-19 vaccine? Findings are positive as they may promote some global confidence in the vaccine, whereas before, dozens of countries temporarily suspended the use of the shot over concerns about possible rare side effects. These recent findings out of Oxford may just be breathing new confidence into this new vaccine. The trial, involving more than 32,000 participants, was the largest of its kind for any COVID vaccine trial. The vaccine was 79% effective overall in preventing symptomatic infections, higher than observed in previous clinical trials. However, this news may not make much difference in the United States, where the vaccine is not yet approved and may not need to be. By May, Pfizer, Moderna, and Johnson & Johnson already plan to have enough doses of the vaccine for the United States, and the AstraZeneca vaccine might not even be needed here at that point. So, what are the side effects of the AstraZeneca vaccine? All four vaccine side effects are similar, including potential injection site pain and flu-like symptoms, including fatigue, fever, headaches, and muscle pains, which are to be expected as your immune system is primed, especially after a second dose. However, at least 10 European nations and Thailand either slowed or suspended AstraZeneca vaccinations, reports of blood clotting in people who had received the shot. The European Medicines Agency insists that the vaccine is safe, citing 30 reported cases of blood clots among 5 million people given the AstraZeneca vaccine across Europe. It is unclear if the events are related, and more research is needed to confirm direct causation. The World Health Organization recommends continuing with inoculations while the concerns are investigated as a precautionary measure. It's important to remember that the vaccines aren't a miracle cure or preventative. They must be combined with masks, hand washing, and physical distancing to work as effectively as possible. No matter which COVID-19 vaccine becomes available to you first, you can feel confident in its ability to protect you, as long as you continue being cautious until positive cases, hospitalizations, and deaths are significantly reduced nationwide and globally. Have you gotten your COVID vaccine, if you were able to? What was your experience like? Did you get the Pfizer or the Moderna? Did you have any side effects? Comment below. I'd love to hear about your experience, and are there any other COVID-19 topics that you'd like to see me make a video about? Please leave me a comment below. And make sure that you subscribe and turn your bell notifications on. When you do that and you hit that like button, you let YouTube know that you'd like to see more videos like this one. All right. Thank you so much for watching, and stay healthy, my friends.